We're in a pub. There's a bar. There's a screen that's a LED light curtain. And a lot of the action goes on the screen, and you interact with the screen.
Liverpool Street Station, London, rush hour.
You rush in to open your laptop. You're really, really busy.
Claire is on the screen. She's out in a field of flowers. He sees her on the screen. Desktop computer opens one more application. Something is... The power goes. It's all dark in the pub. Claire enters the pub. She wears illuminating clothes. She carries a basket from the field and she feeds the audience edible flowers. She takes her skirt off and it's actually a solar panel. And then she draws the curtain on the screen. And the lights back on.
Okay, yeah, okay.
Do you hear music?
Yeah, yeah.
He's very distracted by her. And the computer fights back. He is closing it down. And now she's at the bar, he's trying to impress, and everything goes wrong. So he's dropping the plates on the floor. Let me help you. And then he orders the staff to clear up the mess. You're really embarrassed. You grab her by the hand and say, let's dance. And you watch the screen there. There's a box on his laptop and he's messing with it. Spread in the pub and yellow lights crawl on the walls in the pub, so there are yellow. He's trying to cover up what he's doing. You're running through the pub and you shake them off. What have you done? An infected person staggers up. You shoot him with a gun. Cocktail of Life is a film and your lives. So your family life, the growth of your children, turn into a kind of worldwide story. Then a table cracker style bomb goes off and confetti rains in all of the pub. You're sweeping the confetti up. And you're hacking to get seeds for your garden. You get a phone call, Jack, and you put on your spy coat, hat and shades, and pull out your gun and arrest your wife. And she's put in jail. And Jack is busy providing for your children. So he's trying to give them an iPhone, tablet, Wii games, lollipops, popcorn, and the kids don't want any of it. It's very exhausting, and he's still sweeping up confetti. You put the kids to bed. Now you go to the bar and you flirt with a woman. It's a kind of a thing to do when you're bored and you put your wife in jail. And she starts to dance. Excellent, excellent. And he's just too exhausted to dance. He can't cope. He's not in the mood for it. So you go back to prison. She has ordered a parcel of seeds. Jack is the delivery man in disguise. He pulls all the seeds out of the bag and puts Claire in it and drags her out. The laptop has now begun its own life. There's a big eye watching Claire moving pots around. And whenever you move them in the wrong place, a phone rings. And pick up the phone and you realize you need to follow orders because the pots needs to be organized in a different way. So you start planting in the pots. Take off your dress and make it into a solar panel and you go up to the screen to remove the curtain to get the sunlight. However, the sky is dull and cloudy in a weird way. Secret agents are chasing Jack. Whoa, don't look at him. Jack comes running in his spy outfit and slams the door so things fall down and a few trays rattle in the pops bar. Claire's sitting at the laptop hacking seeds again. Jack gets all worked up, worried she'll get arrested again. He shows her the handcuffs and she says, "I'm not in the mood for it." He realizes that he cannot do other than work together. So he sits next to her and they hack the seed bank together. Jack and Claire are dragging lots of seed bags. Going out on the farm and your children on the screen are running about the field around you. Now you're planting on the farm and you start playing with the dirt. You throw mud at each other. You have a real mud fight. You're wrestling, smudging dirt. The light changes and you realize you are both illuminated with toxins. Your medicine, it's white powder, and the white powder makes you so sick that you faint in bed and you're both under the covers. You're so sick now, and then you start arguing about who's to make tea because I'm so sick I can't make the tea for you. I can't. You wake up together, you raise above it, you start making placards. And you pretend you and let's do something about this. And one placard says no to toxins, and the other says we want sunny skies, but it's drawings. Then Jack makes a love placard and he seduces Claire to go to bed. You can work on it.
Don't do it!
They're making love blend over crowds of people at demonstrations on the screen for environment and peace. Your children are already gone to the demo. They're way more clever than you. They're already there. The eye on the computer screen is big and staring, and what do you do together? You close the lid to the laptop. Now you're carrying the placards around, you're on the demo, you're going around the pub with your placards. Now the laptop is rattling. Trying to open itself. Then the cocktail of life, multicolored virus. The laptop opens and love is all over the pub. All the LED lights turn from yellow to red and there are sort of reflected hearts all over. Jack and Claire and stagehands, you walk around now and serve cocktails with hearts to the customers. Everything, the world is filled with love. The world is filled with love.
Please run this play.
'Mucking about with some loops and some chords and just let it grow and grow and grow. So organically, I had no idea what was happening and I just started with a tempo really. And if you can see, I don't know whether the camera pick it up, but all these tracks here are different. The amber tracks are percussion, the blue one is a bass line, and all the green ones are instruments that I've been playing. But I just thought I'd play it, see what you think. Fun to do it.
So, yeah. Yeah. Well, I think that's what's the strength of this now, that I feel everybody's really enthusiastic.
Mm.
And the first one being, well, obviously me, I'm just sort of gobsmacked. but Si is a good driver in this.
He's positive about
what we do. Have you ever made the backing tracks for renewable energy firms?
No, I've done a lot of backing tracks for different pieces of music for different people.
Yeah.
And it's, and a lot of what I've done is yachts. Wind power yachts. So you get a lot of sort of a racy sort of driving but airy sound with that sort of thing. Yeah. With yachts. But sometimes music has to be like an extra. It has to be part of the scene but not the focus of the scene. But it has to support what's going on stage. So it doesn't have to be the front end of everything. So that's what this is. Supposed to be. it fades in, so. Yeah. Very simple track, there's only three tracks in it.
That's when the lights come back on.
Yeah, yeah. It could be.
She pulls the curtain and, yeah, magical.
I love sounds that move. I like sounds that don't stay there, that actually phase, you know, and move. And in about 30 seconds time, I start bringing in more conventional instruments. This could be a yoga piece, you know, it could be something that people listen to in yoga.
You just added a scene in the play where we all do yoga, it's taken.
Okay, I've done.
We'll put that in.
Yeah.
Excellent. That's your piano.
Now you'll hear, apart from the basic rhythm, which is very slow, but you'll hear a sub rhythm start to form inside the melody, which will be enhanced by strings. Seems to be random, now sort of formed into a more solid place. Do you see what I mean? So now it's much more conventional. And you've still got that sweeping sound behind it, that sort of background sound.
Will you be able to rearrange it once you have the final film of the whole play? Then you can put it in place.
Yeah, all of these notes.
Yeah. Like Italian comedy, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Charlie Chaplin, that style of
da-da. Reeling things,
but it kind of start-stop all the time.
Yeah, there's a couple of ways you can do that. They tend to, well, if you use traditional older instruments, then you're reminding people of that sort of essence.
Yeah.
So you'd have things like soprano saxophones, you know, like the clarinets, that sort of, the old jazz instruments, things like that, jazz instruments, pianos.
Mm. I look forward to hearing that.
Winter moth, you must be cold. Winter moth, not very old. Winter moth, what do you eat? Winter moth, where do you sleep? Winter moth, this breezy day, winter moth is blown away. Winter moth, where did you go? Winter moth, I'll never know. I'm an advanced salsa dancer, but I'm not a professional dancer.
Do you take an interest in using the choreography of this play? Can you imagine that something could be done?
Yes, I think so. I'm not too sure about wearing a solar panel dress, but I'm sure that can be designed.
Do you know how to dance salsa?
Oh, when I dance, it's like being at a wedding. I don't know how, but it won't be here.
Can you show him a bit of salsa, please?
Yes. Yeah,
let's see. Whoops.
So you mirror my feet, so it's a one, two, three, and then that foot goes back, five, tap, seven. So it's a forward, tap, three, back, tap,